Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem on square threaded screw. For that purpose, here we have a question. A square threaded screw of 24mm outside diameter and 5mm pitch. In order to drive the tool carriage, the screw exerts an axial pressure of 2.5 kN. Find the efficiency of the screw and power required to drive the screw if it is to rotate at 30 rpm. Assume coefficient of friction of screw threads as 0.12. So this is the question on square threaded screw. Now whatever is given here, I will write that in the form of data first. The first step is, in the data we have to write down which type of screw is it. So here I'll mention that the type of screw, it is square threaded screw. Next, a square threaded screw of 24mm outside diameter and 5mm pitch. So the outside diameter is 24mm and pitch is equal to 5mm. In order to drive the tool carriage, the screw exerts an axial pressure of 2.5 kN. This axial pressure is nothing but axial force, or we can say axial thrust. So that I'll denote it by W is equal to 2.5 kN. So in other words, it is 2.5 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. The question is to find the efficiency of the screw and power required to drive the screw. So the first question is to find efficiency of screw, that is eta screw, and power required to drive the screw. So these are two unknowns which we have to calculate. If it is to rotate at 30 rpm, speed is given. I'll denote speed by capital N, that is 30 rpm. Assume coefficient of friction of screw threads as 0.12. So mu value, that is 0.12. So here we have a question. Now let us try to get the solution for this problem. I'll start the solution here. In this solution, since it is given that the thread is of screw thread, so I'll draw the diagram, that is the profile of the screw thread. It will look something like this when we are looking it from the front. Now here, this diagram which I have drawn, it is a profile of a square threaded screw. Here the outer diameter is called as DO, the minimum diameter is called as DC, and here I am marking the mean diameter. This is small d. So now this profile of a square threaded screw, I'll write here that this is a square threaded screw. Now when I'm starting the solution for this, since I know the value of DO and pitch in the data, it is given that DO and pitch are there. So from that I'll calculate this mean diameter. I'll say that since mean diameter of square threaded screw, that mean diameter is small d, and it is given by the formula of DO minus pitch by 2. Now by using this formula I can get D. DO is 24, pitch is 5, so I'll get small d value as 21.5 mm. So this much is the mean diameter of square threaded screw. Next, if I look into the question, the first question is to calculate efficiency of screw. So I'll write down, since efficiency of screw is given by, the formula of efficiency of screw is, it is equal to ideal effort upon actual effort. This is the formula for efficiency of screw. Therefore, eta screw, that is the efficiency, is equal to ideal effort, I'll denote it by P0, upon actual effort, I'll denote it by P. And I will keep this as my equation number 1. Now, as I can see here, we have two unknown values, that is of ideal effort and actual effort. So once we are able to calculate these two values, we can easily find out the efficiency of screw. So now I'll say that, therefore, here I'll explain a small concept. Now this, I'm drawing another profile. Now see, whenever we are talking about a screw is that member which while rotating it will even translate, that is when it is rotated it can even move in the axial direction. So here I have denoted that if the screw is rotating by pi d revolution, that is if it covers the distance equal to circumference, that is one complete rotation, in that case it moves ahead by a distance of pitch. So here the angle which I am getting, it is called as alpha, which is helix angle. So now I can say that therefore tan of alpha will be equal to opposite side by adjacent side. So it is P upon pi d. So therefore tan alpha is equal to, pitch is given as 5 and pi d we have got it as 21.5. So from this, if I calculate my answer of tan alpha, that comes out to be 0.074. After getting tan alpha, I can say that now, since coefficient of friction mu is equal to tan of the friction angle, which is phi, so therefore mu value is known to us, and hence tan phi will be equal to mu. The value is 0.12. Now once I have these two values, I can easily calculate ideal effort and actual effort. So now ideal effort, it is P0 and given by the formula W tan alpha. Hence P0 will be equal to, W is given in the problem, it is 2.5 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Tan alpha, we have got the value as 0.074. So from this, I will get ideal effort value, that is 185 Newton. After getting ideal effort, I'll go on for the calculation of actual effort. Now, since actual effort P, it is given by the formula W into bracket tan alpha plus tan phi upon 1 minus tan alpha into tan phi. So therefore P is equal to W is 2.5 into 10 raised to 3 tan alpha 0.074 plus tan phi is equal to mu, that was 0.12, upon 1 minus 0.074 into 0.12, and here I am getting my answer of actual effort as 489.35 Newton. So after getting ideal and actual effort, I'll put the values in equation number 1. Therefore, put P0 and P in equation number 1. So here I have, in equation 1, efficiency of screw is equal to, it was P0 by P as written here. So it is 185 upon 489.35. So here if I calculate my answer of efficiency of screw, that comes out to be 0.37805, or if I multiply it by 100, the answer is 37.81%. So this is our first answer, efficiency of screw. Now the second part of the question, they are saying us to calculate how much power is transmitted by this screw. So I'll say that since power transmitted by screw, it is given by the formula 2 pi nt upon 60. I'll keep this as equation number 2nd. So here, if I am able to calculate the value of torque, because RPM is given as 30 and this torque will be actual torque. So once I get this value, power can be calculated. So I'll say that therefore, actual torque T is equal to actual effort into the radius of screw thread. So therefore T will be equal to, actual effort was 489.35 into D, it was 21.5 by 2. So from this I will get my value of torque, that comes out to be, it is 5.26 into 10 raised to 3 Newton millimeters, or if I want to convert it into Newton meter, I'll have to divide it by 1000. So here it is 5.26 Newton meter. So after this I'll say that put all values in equation number 2. So therefore power P is equal to 2 pi into 30, which is RPM, multiplied by torque is 5.26 divided by 60. So hence power value is 16.52 watts. This is the second answer. So now, as we have seen in this video, there were two unknowns here. Here we had to calculate the efficiency of screw thread and power transmitted by the screw. And with this, we complete the problem.